The Frankie DeBusk Show is a special presentation of the Pioneer Sports Network. The Frankie DeBusk Show with head coach Frankie DeBusk and the voice of the Pioneers, Brian Stayton.
The Frankie DeBusk Show is presented by your Greenville Light and Power System, serving Greenville and Greene County since 1945. Andrew Johnson Bank, a strong heritage, a stronger future. Home-owned and operated with locations in Johnson City, Jonesboro, Morristown, Cleveland, and Greenville. Special consideration from Comcast Cable through Xfinity.
And now, the voice of the Pioneers, Brian Stayton. Welcome back to the Frankie DeBusk Show. Once again, the voice of the Pioneers, Brian Stayton.
Tusculum Pioneers and the Lenoir Rhyne Bears for the 19th time as we open up conference play. Hello again, everyone. Brian Stayton for the Frankie DeBusk Show, to be joined by Pioneer coach Frankie DeBusk. In desperate need of win number 94 for his career, the four-time defending conference champion LR Bears were coming to Pioneer Field. It was about 3 years ago when the Pioneers were taking on the Bears, who were just starting their swoon as the best team in the conference, and Tusculum knocked them off 26-25. Little did we know then it would be their only loss of the year on their way to the NCAA playoffs and a South Atlantic Conference championship. Tusculum needed something. They were reaching. You know, through the first two games of the year, they've given up a plethora of points on the first drive, 14, and they're giving up a plethora of yards on the first drive, nearly 150 yards against the opposition. Meanwhile, they're resulting 0-7 on their first two drives combined on offense, needing something. They were hoping for the Smoky Gray. Smoky gray uniforms at an orange and black school. However, it worked. They were pumped up. They've got this nice looking uniform. They were ready to go. We were hoping they were ready to go as well. Well, they were aggressive as they won the opening toss and they decided to receive, and then they didn't move the ball, and LR did move the ball. Well, for the Pioneers, a heartbreaking triple overtime 55-52 loss to the Bears. LR's Kyle Duggar forced and recovered the game-winning fumble in the third overtime period as the Bears knocked off Tusculum. After the Tusculum defense held LR out of the end zone to start the third overtime, Hunter Hare connected on a 24-yard field goal. On Tusculum's first offensive play of the third overtime period, quarterback Luke Lancaster completed a 5-yard pass to Kenny Funny. We assumed that the play was over. We also assumed that Kenny Funny was down. Initial progress stopped at the 20, but Kyle Duggar did not give up. He came out of the pile with the football, sending the Bears into delirium. As you see, he's down. However, to the naked eye, and as fast as it may or may not have happened, the officials, after a very lengthy discussion, ruled that the game then was over. Well, you never want to be a referee knowing that there was controversy on the play, but the game ended in controversy. It was a contest that was decided by a big defensive play at the end. The game was dominated by both offenses, however. The two programs combined for 107 points, 1,161 yards, 65 first downs, and established three school records. The teams also combined for 8 turnovers, 4 apiece. LR rushed for 591 on a school single game record 89 attempts. Quarterback Evan Sims rushed for a career-best 252 on 29 attempts, including 4 touchdowns. His 252-yard effort is the third-best rushing tally in school history. And teammate Kristen Ivory ran for 213 yards and 2 scores. Now, Tusculum established team records with 35 first downs and 74 pass attempts. Sophomore quarterback Luke Lancaster threw for 452 and 6 touchdowns and started the game 2-for-13. His touchdowns, the 6, second most in school history in a game. Lancaster accounted for 42 completions and a school record 73 attempts. Tusculum senior Justin Houston hauled in 15 catches and 155 yards and a career-best 3 touchdowns. He's tied for the second most ever in a Tusculum single game. Teammate Kenny Funny had 182 yards on 13 receptions and a pair of touchdowns. On defense, there was some play. Akeem Peoples led all players with a career-high 14 tackles for the Pioneers, including 1 for loss and a fumble recovery. Brandon Bartlett added 13 tackles, forced 2 fumbles, and recovered another, while Lakeith Brown finished with 11 stops and forced a turnover. Cliff Barrett led the Bears with 13 tackles. Lancaster's 452-yard passing performance was his second 400-plus effort of the young season, just his third game, and the ninth most in school history. His six touchdown tosses were just one shy of the school record that Bo Cordell threw against Brevard in 2010. Houston's three touchdown receptions gives him 19 for his career, which are now tied for the third most by a Pioneer. He moves into sole possession of second place in school history with 2,682 receiving yards, 246 yards shy of the school record held by Rashad Carter. Yes, he was just a freshman. Saturday was also his 12th game with 100 receiving yards, which is tied for the most in school history. The Tusculum Pioneers lose a heartbreaker after a lot of numbers are attained in the contest against the LR Bears. Well, the guy who won't necessarily want to sit down and talk to us about it will come and do that. We're not going to sit there and think there's controversial, but the Pioneers lost a game that maybe they shouldn't have lost. And unfortunately, it's in the hands of somebody else. Come back with us for more of the Frankie DeBusk Show.
Your Greenville Light and Power System, an electrical distributor of TVA, serving Greenville and Greene County since 1945. Your Greenville Light and Power is dedicated to excellence in service and reliability. Visit online at glps.net.
Showtime. You know what it is. Everything we do it big. Screaming, that's not nine. When we step up on the field, that's nine. Small town, but we still do it very big. Back in Mars, back in Mars, back in Mars, back in Mars. We grind hard for the rings with the diamonds on it. Back in Mars, back in Mars, back in Mars, back in Mars.
Welcome back into the Frankie DeBusk Show. The Tusculum Pioneers drop a hard-fought contest to the LR Bears this past Saturday as both teams open up conference play. Rejoined by Pioneer coach Frankie DeBusk, a game that you maybe is a tone setter for LR. They want to prove the fact that they maybe what they had the week before against North Greenville wasn't their football team. And for you, you want to prove that against Virginia State, that's not our football team. And I really think both teams came out and made good statements.
Oh, absolutely. The head coach and I for LR spoke before the game and said we would know a little bit more about our teams after the game because we'd played, you know, two opponents we weren't really used to playing. And obviously, it went down to the very, very last play, and a lot of plays were made in that ball game. A lot of people made some mistakes along the way, made some big plays along the way, and I'm just really proud of how hard our kids fought back. We never laid down. There's plenty of opportunities we could have laid down and not even got back in the ball game, but kept fighting, kept clawing, kept putting ourselves. I told them at halftime, let's put ourselves in position to make it a one-possession game, to have a chance to win the ball game, and obviously we did that and put ourselves in position to win it, and unfortunately, came up short on the end.
Well, there's just a lot to get to, so we'll go ahead and get to those highlights. Let's take a look at your first half highlights. Tusculum versus Lenoir Rhyne. These teams meeting for the 19th time. Tusculum has 10 wins in the series against the Bears. It's the most wins against a South Atlantic Conference opponent. Luke Lancaster, little did he know after his start, which was extremely tough, that he would have a banner day and coach a Chamber of Commerce type day to play football at Pioneer.
It was an awesome day, man. We had a lot of recruits were here. The crowd was great. Our facilities people, David Martin, Chad Grindstaff, Buster Scott, those guys just do an unbelievable job getting us ready week in and week out. The field was phenomenal. The day was phenomenal. Everything was perfect except those 3 points. They scored more than we did, Brian.
The LR Bears would have the ball the second possession. Tusculum won the toss, and they decided to receive. I like that aggression by Mark Kolb and this Pioneer team to get it, but they had a three and out. So LR would get the ball and just methodically move down the field as they have. Calvin Edwards, Kristen Ivory, Michael Patrick, Evan Sims, all part of this first drive, and Sims would punch it in from 2 yards away. And it would be a 13-play, 67-yard drive, 4:55 off the clock. And we're thinking, we've got to give our defense a break. And the Pioneer offense would come out, and the first play would go to Isaac Robinson. And we're thinking, we can't go three and out again.
That's exactly what I was saying, Brown. We had to have some success. And thought we had a really good plan, and this is just a really good throw. And from the end zone, you could see Kenny Funny making that one move that he made there and taking it and scored. Just a great athlete, good call, good throw, good catch. Great job getting us on the ball, on the scoreboard.
However, it only took 51 seconds to play 75 yards, and the defense didn't have a whole lot of chance to get a lot of rest, but there may be a better step. No, it's just a good plan by LR. Evan Sims right up the middle for 39.
Yeah, unfortunately, again, Brian, we got to make them punt the football. They didn't punt it in the first half. And defensively, we were flying around. We just had a lot of missed tackles. Had a lot of guys with a lot of tackles on Saturday, but we had a lot of guys with a lot of missed tackles. And unfortunately, that's not going to win you many ball games.
Mike Iese said, let's win our zone, and I think the guys were really concerned about their zone on this play.
Yeah, we didn't do a very good job. We knew we were going to get cut. We got to defeat the cut a little better, and they got a great plan. Don't get me wrong. They move the football on everybody they play. They get yards and points on everybody they play, and we finally settled down and played a little better in the second half, but we got to keep it going there. Kenny needs to make that catch, and I thought we did a great job protecting the passer up front. Luke made some good throws. He also made some bad throws, as you see there, throwing an interception to number 12 and just letting it get out of his hands a little bit high. And didn't have a very good start once again for whatever reason that may be, but we did rebound and put some points on the board.
Pioneers down 14-7. They do throw the interception, and then the Pioneers, defensively stringing it out. Lakeith Brown had a big game, and then, again, really making it tough on the run on this particular possession is when you had them backed up. And a Pioneer team that then, has a little bit of fortune here on this defensive drive, too.
Yeah, I thought we started playing a little better as the game went along. We had a good plan, and we were there. We just weren't making many plays. And, here we're defeating the cut, but he also makes a good decision or bad decision. We get the football, and great job our defense flying around. Great job getting us the ball back, and we're in good position here.
Pioneers take over the football once again. This is the end of the first quarter. Tusculum trails LR by a score of 14-7. Pioneers unable to move the ball, so this is the ensuing possession for the LR Bears, and they would eventually punch this one in as well. Kristen Ivory out of Los Angeles, he had a big day on the day as well. He went over 200 yards rushing. He would punch it in. The point would be good. It's 21-7, 13 plays, 75 yards, 5:28 off the clock. And the Pioneers feel as if they've really got to make a statement, and the offense comes out and makes a really nice statement.
Makes some good decisions. There's Luke hitting Justin Houston. Great job, our kids up front protecting us. And flip it out here again to Justin. And great job blocking on the end there. I think that's Jordan Barnes blocking there for Justin downfield. And our kids do a great job on the outside blocking for him. And here we protect real well. And great throw and catch to Drew Schrader, tight end over there in Cosby, Tennessee. Makes a great catch for us. I think that's his third catch of the year. And here's a good run by Isaac Robinson. It'd be nice if he'd make that free safety miss and get on the end zone. But a good job up front by our kids blocking, and Patrick Benson and several of those guys, Mexico Bear. And here we do a great job protecting. As you can see, we're no pressure coming. And Luke stands up nice and tall. He throws a great ball anyway. And this is just a great throw. And nice job getting 1 foot down and catching the football for six.
That's on third down, too. You're making that throw on third down. You're throwing it to an All-American, so you feel pretty good about it. The drive is 10 plays, 69 yards, 3:53 off the clock. LR leads the game 21-14. A field goal was made by the LR Bears right at the end of the first half. The Pioneers would have the ball, and Luke Lancaster would get intercepted by Kyle Duggar, and then the LR Bears would take a knee for the most part, and in the first half, they would receive the second half kickoff as well. So it's a game. It's one of those games. You're down by just 10 points at halftime, and the Pioneers are looking to hold in the second half. Will they? Find out when we come back. There's still a lot to go here on the Frankie DeBusk Show.
Andrew Johnson Bank was founded on conservative banking principles. Over the last 30 years, they have steadily built their balance sheet and increased capital by following prudent lending principles and avoiding risky investments. In uncertain times, you can continue to count on Andrew Johnson Bank, your locally owned community bank. A strong heritage, a stronger future. Andrew Johnson Bank, member FDIC. Lewis looking, left-hander gets rid of it, throws it deep. It's going to be picked off at the 40. At the 35, spinning is Cam Thomas, and he'll go down at the 26. But it's a turnover, and the Pioneers have the ball, leading 24-21.
This is Cam Killer Thomas, and let's get back to the game once again. Brown State.
Welcome back into the Frankie DeBusk Show. The Tusculum Pioneers trail Lenoir Rhyne at the end of the first half by a score of 24-14. This is all too familiar for the Pioneers here of late, trailing at halftime, but making really good statements in the second half for the most part. You needed a statement, Coach. I really think LR came out thinking that they were going to set the tone in the second half with the football.
Yeah, I thought we actually were a completely different team again, Brian, in the second half. Don't know why we're not doing it early in the game, but came out, played really hard, was flying around, made a bunch of plays. Again, made too many mistakes along the way, but was very pleased with our effort for sure.
Let's go ahead and get to it, because there's a lot to this with three overtimes, the Tusculum Pioneers and the LR Bears. As we start our coverage here in the second half, the LR Bears will have the football, and immediately out of the gate, you think, oh no, here we go with a big run for the Bears.
That's exactly what I said. You know, there they hand it off to number three, breaks a few tackles. We got to get him on the ground when we got a chance to, and he looks like he's off to the races. I think Martez Tompkins runs him down there about the 10-yard line, but not the ideal way to start the second half for the Pioneers.
Kristen Ivory for 64 yards, then Michael Patrick right up the middle, and this is an opportunistic defense, the Pioneer defense, that leads the South Atlantic Conference in takeaways, the top 10 team in the nation in that, and they were very successful on this day too.
Excellent job there by Brandon Bartlett, linebacker from down in the, near the Atlanta, Georgia area, gets a huge strip and hangs on to the ball, and you never know what's going to happen in the game of football. We had a big 60-yard run against us. We turn around and get the ball the next snap. That's the fortune that we need to have happen for us. Great job making a play.
It delayed the inevitable. The Pioneers would be forced to punt the ball away. One play, and Evan Sims would take it to the house.
Yes, this is another opportunity for us to get one on the ground, and we failed to do so. And he's a very athletic quarterback. And, again, talk about bang, bang, bang plays. That's the way the second half went.
All right, 31-14. The Bears would lead the football game, but that would be their last best offensive series, and now Josh Jackson, the freshman out of Loudoun, would get involved.
Yeah, proud of Josh's efforts. He runs the football hard for us, makes some guys miss, sticks it up in there, gets a big first down here. We needed something good to happen, and we're getting him the football, and he's having some success. We flip it out to Justin, and makes a guy miss, and there's Evan Altizer blocking for him downfield, and we're moving the chains once again.
That's a third down play for the Pioneers, and again, weren't successful early, but started to pick it up on third downs late. They drive Wood Stall, and here it is on fourth down. And, we called you the riverboat gambler before, but I realized we could not see our punt team the rest of this game.
Yeah, I was sort of hoping we weren't going to get this called back on us, but it was a great execution there, great job. Our punter, not overthrowing that guy. I wish he would have thrown a little better to Evan, but you run a fake punt. If it works, you feel good. If it don't, you feel like a goat. And there, we actually had some success.
Second down and 10, and crossing pattern to Justin Houston, who did have a banner day, proving why he's arguably maybe one of the most, if not the most, dangerous wide receiver in the league. On second and 10, goes for 13 yards, and now Ken Drummond gets involved as well.
Great catch here by Drummond. He had some action there for us on Saturday, made a big catch down inside the 5-yard line, and gives us some life. And here Kenny's got to make this catch, but he doesn't. Ball flips up, and there's Ken Drummond in the right place at the right time, making a great catch, and his first touchdown as a Pioneer, I do believe.
Not even close. I mean, they sat there and talked about it for a good little while to make sure that he had actually caught the ball. Everybody's saying that he caught the ball, and we're sitting there on the radio, did he catch the ball? Nobody's arms went up until much later. 14 plays, 81 yards, 4:40 off the clock. The point was blocked by Paul Sloan, so the score was 31-20. Defensively, LR, their last great series offensively, I should say, and the Pioneers, again, bending, but eventually not breaking.
Yeah, we're flying around now. We're starting to do some things different. I think we'll get another turnover right here. Kids are just really just executing, doing the best thing that we can ask them to do right now. We're making those tackles when we were missing them in the first half, and here we do another good job of stripping him there. I'm not even sure who that is. I think that's Akeem Peoples doing a great job stripping that running back and getting the football, and unfortunately, it comes back to haunt us there on the last play of the game. But great job by our guys stripping the football and getting it from them and giving us a chance to get the ball back.
It's a team in LR that when they do fumble, that's kind of the Achilles heel with, but you know, as far as pitching, it's 7 fumbles on the day when they only lost 4 of them. But that punt team did come back out. But again, some fortune shining on the Pioneers.
Yep, great job flying around here, getting after it, trying to get on the football. Their guy doesn't do what he's supposed to do, and we're flying around, and I'm not sure gets on the fumble there, but great effort. Is it Evan Gates? Great effort by us getting the ball back and end up having to kick a field goal, but Will Tommy comes in, and Will's just an unbelievable kicker for us, having a great year as a freshman and a true weapon, and it gets us within a 1-score ball game like we wanted to be.
30-yard field goal makes it 31-23. LR Bears on the ensuing offensive series, and Pioneers really flying around, winning their area, and I think that was the key this week. Just win your zone and do your job. And Akeem Peoples with the biggest hit of the day. And then on third down and a yard, I thought this was very impressive because the Cameron Thomas comes up and knocks him out of bounds.
Yes, he did. Kept him from getting the first down there, putting him in fourth down. First time they have to punt for the day, and we're finally starting to execute a little better defensively.
Going into the fourth quarter, now the Pioneers going into the sun and into the wind, into the west end zone, and the offense really starts to click.
Yep, we start hitting a little under out there. Good calls by Mark Colbin. Kenny Funny making a catch, making a guy miss, and moving the chains.
Kenny Funny for 13 yards, then it's second down and 10. If it worked once, might as well go to it again. This is not the same play. It is a different play, and Funny picks up 13 more yards.
Great job, our kids up front protecting, and unfortunately here, Eric Lynch got to hang on to the football. Was wanting that ball to get out of bounds so bad, and they do a good job here scooping and scoring, and we feel like we got some momentum, and then all of a sudden that happens to us.
Kyle Duggar likely will be the defensive conference player of the week, had a big day, had a touchdown there, and later on he'll be involved in another play, also had an interception. Pioneers, Luke Lancaster, though, would not give up, looking and finding Justin Houston for 11 yards. Then it's third down and three, Kenny Funny for just a couple of yards. Really thought he was going to get outside and break this, and so now it's fourth down and a yard.
Yeah, we, again, the situation that we're in, got to find a way to get us a first, and we hand it to Josh, and Josh breaks a few tackles, and moves the chains for us. Great job by our kids up front, and great job by Josh Jackson and getting us a first down.
13 carries, 55 yards for Jackson. Crossing pattern for Rodnell Cruel. Thought he was going to score as well, but that grass monster got him.
Yeah, that sure jumped up and bit him there. Rodnell, wish he had that one back. But great throw here, great catch by Justin Houston, another big touchdown.
Right in front of the South Atlantic Conference Commissioner, Patrick Briggs.
I see Patrick there.
We go, and he would fix the pylon cone as well. Justin Houston with the touchdown for the Pioneers. From 8 yards away, 11 plays, 75 yards, 2:44 off the clock. The score is 38-30 for Tusculum. They would hold, force another punt, give it to Josh Jackson. The longest running play of the year, that was at 13 yards. Then it's second down and 10. Here's Justin Houston for 12 more yards.
Yeah, is this a series? We do not have any timeouts, Brian.
And not
we, yet. Okay, we're not to that point yet. But great job there by Josh Jackson again, moving the chains. And Luke's making some really good decisions here, throwing and catching. Here's Jordan Barnes making a big catch. Jordan continues to get better each and every week, young man from over in South Carolina. And here I think we go back to Kenny Funny and get 7 or 8 more yards, break another tackle. Things are rolling good for us now as an offense.
So for the Pioneers, they had first and goal, but then a false start moved them back, and Josh Jackson takes it down to about the 2. There's that guy once again, Duggar, who really makes a touchdown-saving play. So it's third down and goal, Jackson for just a yard. And now it's fourth down and goal.
Yeah, I forget. I didn't want to remember this, Brian. We've got to do a better job blocking this play. And fourth and goal, I know they're all pinching in there, but we got to be able to get a yard. And again, you think we can hang our heads and be discouraged, but we don't. We hold them, we get the ball back, and we go back to work.
You do hold them, force a punt. You have 2 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the football game, and now you are out of timeouts on this drive. Second and 10, Funny for 13 yards. Here's Josh Jackson, who really shows his hands. Isaac Robinson had a few drops. Jackson didn't. He picks up on third down and 10, an 11-yard pickup. Now it's second down and 4. Justin Houston for 13 more yards.
Great calls by Mark Kolb here, giving us a chance, and good execution by our offensive guys. And offensive line's doing their part. Receivers doing their part. We're picking up blitzes. We're throwing and catching. We got to get that one down a little bit, but we're not going to complete them all. I'm aware of that. But just a great drive by our offensive football team.
Third down and 3, and this nice catch by Kenny or Rodnell Cruel for the Pioneers for 7 yards. Now it's third down and 3, and Kenny Funny picks up a first down. Then on first and goal, Josh Jackson gets into the end zone.
Got to have a 2-point conversion here. It's a great effort for us to score, but we're still down 2, and we're about out of juice. We got some guys trying to tap out, so we take our time here. And Mark makes a good call. Justin makes a great route and or runs a good route, and Luke makes a good throw, and it's 38-38.
2-point conversion, 11 plays, 60 yards, and 1:50, and now we go overtime, 38-38. The Bears would have the ball first to start this overtime period, and they weren't good on long distance, but give them a short field, and they were pretty good. Kristen Ivory would find a way to get close to the end zone and then punch it in.
We got to tackle him right there. We got people out there. We're flying around. We just got to get him on the dang on ground. I know he's a good player, but we got guys out there. We got to get him on the ground when it's 4th and 1 there, and then he punches it in from 2 on 2nd down there, and we're making some plays, but again, we're missing our share as well.
You know what you needed, and you need 7 points, and you go to Kenny Funny, 2nd down and 10. This goes for 9 yards. Pick up the 3rd down on Josh Jackson, then 2nd down and 10. This is really a nice play.
Yeah, this is. This is a great job. This is a good call. It's a good route. It's a good throw. Obviously, we got to make the extra point here to keep it tied up, but we're not backing down. We're continuing to compete and battle, and just really proud of how hard our kids played on Saturday.
Kenny Funny, 13 catches, 182 yards, 2 touchdowns, a long of 74. Justin Houston, 15 catches, 155 yards. We go to the second overtime. You're going to see his third touchdown of the day, this one from 25 yards.
Great throw there. Justin Houston doing what he has to do, making the guy miss. He really doesn't need to turn that flip in the end zone. That could have cost us yards on the extra point attempt. But great job to execute by the offense. First play there of the second overtime to give us points.
LR Bears know what they need. They need 7 points. And from the 25, they would continue to go to the west end zone. Evan Sims, a quarterback who had a big day, banner day, career day, 29 carries, 252 yards, and 4 touchdowns, could likely be the offensive player of the week. Kristen Ivory had 26 carries for 213 yards. They do get the touchdown. Sims from 3 yards away. The hair kick was good, tying the game at 52. And we go to the third overtime. This time they go to the east end zone. Really thought fortune was going to smile on us again, but Michael Patrick didn't pitch the ball.
I did too. I thought we had an opportunity there. They were running a little double pitch. They'd ran that once in the games we had watched. And they get the ball on the 12-yard line due to a penalty that we had, 12.5-yard line due to a penalty we had on that last score. And thinking they may score, we decided to give them the ball first. And they kick a field goal, so we know we needed a touchdown to win it. And this is an unfortunate, our luck didn't go our way right here at the very end.
Really thought when you held them to the field goal that the game was over, because I honestly believe that because they hadn't stopped us that they wouldn't. And controversy at the end of the game, unfortunately. The officials are going to sit here and talk about it. We're going to show you a little bit closer look of it and slow it down a little bit. Everybody, even Justin Houston and Kenny Funny, are sitting there arguing their case. He's down. We're ready to play. If it takes this long to confirm, then I don't think anybody truthfully knows. It's just unfortunate.
Yeah, just very unfortunate for us. I don't agree with the call, but that was what they made there, and we got to hang on to the ball a little better and not put ourselves in that situation. But I do believe we were down, and we'll see it here in slow motion. But that's part of the game. There's Kenny's knees, elbows down, knees down, and he rips it out late. But that's the way the ball goes sometimes.
So it's evident that the elbow and the wrist hit the ground first, which unfortunately. In Division One, everywhere else, that's going to be reviewed, and that would have been obviously seen. It's 0.7 seconds to the naked eye, real time. You're watching the knees. Maybe the knee wasn't quite down, but it's evident that the elbow was down, as people have already seen in some steel shots in this show. Coach, unfortunate. It's 3 overtimes. There's a lot of emotion at the end of a game like that. Didn't really get a chance to talk to any of the guys because I think they were just dumbfounded. I know you don't want to get blown out, but that's got to be the worst way to lose a football game.
Well, there was a lot of positives we'll take from that, Brian. I mean, I'm a glass half full guy. We made a lot of plays. Our kids fought like crazy, and we were behind and could have every easy thrown in the towel. We found a way to compete and get back in it, and we didn't get in there on fourth down and late in the ball game. You think it's over. We keep fighting. Give up big runs defensively, but we find a way to get turnovers inside the 10-yard line. There's a lot of emotion in those kind of games, and a lot of big plays were made, and unfortunately it didn't go our way. And we had a lot of disappointed and discouraged young men after the game, and a lot of tears were flowing. But I tried to explain to them that I was not discouraged at all in our effort. I thought we gave tremendous effort, and hopefully we'll learn some things from this ball game.
I'll give you a discouraging stat, and I know I'm not saying this to pick or pry, but it's a theme, and I think it's a glaring thing for this Pioneer football team, even though they did score for the first time in the first quarter. Three opponents, their first 3 drives have netted 221, 21 points. And the Pioneers' first 3 drives of games, no first downs, 7 total yards, and 0 points. And that's offense, and that's just offense and defense. And whether or not it's young kids a little bit scared and timid and trying to figure out what's going on, I think that really is the glaring thing. You put forth the effort to get back into the game, but we sit here and analyze games and realize we can actually have leads.
Absolutely. Well, we come out in new uniforms Saturday trying to give us the boost that we needed. We looked great. I was very proud, very thankful Russell worked with us there. But Russell Corporation, but you know, we don't get jump started early. We give up points early. We're not moving the football. We're not getting first downs, and that goes back to the football staff. We got to figure out ways to execute and get it done. And we talk about it a lot. We had a great game plan. We got to go back to the drawing board and figure out why it's happening the way that it's happening. But that is an issue that we got to address.
How pumped up were the kids when they
saw my gosh, fired up! They were like kindergartners. We got a little video. My son. Shot the video in the locker room. We showed it to him on Friday, so we need to get that to you and let you see it.
It's a lot of the kids nowadays with these, how everybody's unveiling their uniforms. They've got the sunshade visor, and they come in and they're all ripped, and everybody's, and Laurante Archie got to be that guy.
Right,
was probably more pumped up.
Oh, he was fired up. He said he was ready to go play.
Unfortunately, he couldn't play for the Pioneers because he's used his eligibility, and the Pioneers have fallen to the four-time conference champion Lenoir Rhyne Bears this past Saturday. That series goes now 10-9 in favor of the Pioneers. We'll go to Hickory next year and try to get some revenge on that bare-bone attack of Ian Shields and Lenoir Rhyne. When we come back, some of the players who were credited for a great comeback bid effort. That's when we come back with more of the Frankie DeBusk Show.
Your Greenville Light and Power System, an electrical distributor of TVA, serving Greenville and Greene County since 1945. Your Greenville Light and Power is dedicated to excellence in service and reliability. Visit online at glps.net.
Welcome back to the Frankie DeBusk Show. Once again, the voice of the Pioneers, Ryan Stayton.
Welcome back into the Frankie DeBusk Show. The Pioneers drop a heartbreaker to the Bears of Lenoir Rhyne University. Sometimes you just have to tip your cap, and that's what we'll do with the Bears this week because they escaped Pioneer Field in three overtimes with a 55-52 win. A lot of guys, a lot of blood, sweat, and tears, a lot of heartbreak on the field after the contest. And you go down there with a camera or a microphone, and most guys want to come and talk to you. This time, most of these guys were just shying away. We understood that this week. Next week, we'll promise to have you, somebody in front of the camera, talking about the game for the team. As it is now, plenty of guys who had big days. Luke Lancaster had a huge day, obviously. We've talked about that in our open. We talked about Justin Houston, and we talked about Kenny Funny and what he had done in the game to get the Pioneers to that third overtime to begin with. Our offensive player of the week this week is a young freshman out of Loudoun, Tennessee, from Loudoun High School. He's Josh Jackson. Might not have had the game necessarily that these other players may have had on offense, but he came in and definitely set a tone in the running game that allowed this passing game to flourish. He had 13 carries, 55 yards, a long of 13, which is the longest rush of the year, including a touchdown in the game. Defensive players, there were plenty. Cam Thomas had a big day. There were plenty of stat sheet stuffers like Brandon Bartlett, along with Akeem Peoples. There's Zach Lane, who did an outstanding job. But the focus this week on defense was win your area. DeShay Williams won his area. Out of Laurel, Mississippi, Mississippi Gulf Coast, he had just two tackles, but nobody came into his area. Our special teams players of the week, a redshirt freshman out of Woodruff, South Carolina, from Woodruff High School. He's Ken Drummond. He plays wide receiver, but on special teams was outstanding, finishing with two tackles. Also had two catches for 22 yards in his first career, receiving touchdown on a deflection. And our true freshman kicker, Will Tommy, the freshman out of Greenwood, South Carolina, from Emerald High School. 5 of 6 on point afters, 1-for-1 field goal, and also had 5 touchbacks. Our call of the game is maybe not the necessary play of the game, but you can't have this play without what having happened at the end of the game. No, it may not have been that necessary call, but it was necessary to get it to overtime. The end of the game was horrible and controversial as it was, but to get there, we had to have a game-tying touchdown and 2-point conversion. That's our call of the game.
The Bears not set. They give it to Jackson, who powers in for the touchdown. Touchdown, Josh Jackson. Touchdown, Pioneers. The 2-point conversion must be converted to tie it with 39 seconds in the game. The snap. Lancaster looks to Houston. We're tied. Justin Houston from Lancaster, and the Pioneers have roared back.
Time now for your post-game wrap-up. In the game, we have talked at length about many of the records. Tusculum with 35 first downs. LR had 30 in the contest. LR, all of their offense came basically on the ground. 591 yards, 89 attempts. Pioneers did get 99 yards on the ground. Passing, the Bears had a big fat zero. Pioneers 471 yards through the air. Total offense, LR 92 plays, 591 yards. The Pioneers ran 100 plays in the game, as there were three overtimes, for 570 yards on the day, and a day in which we felt the Pioneers would only run 50 plays or so on the day. Cantrell had a 39.2 yard average, as LR's punter a 45.7 yard average on the day. Time of possession, LR 32 minutes 8 seconds, Tusculum 27 minutes and 52 seconds. Third down conversions, LR was great early, they were 8 of 18, Tusculum finished 8 of 17. Fourth downs, LR 2 for 2, that one non-conversion for the Pioneers loomed large, they finished 2 for 3. On third downs, on fourth downs, pardon me. Red zone scoring, LR 7 of 9, Tusculum was 6 of 7. And the toughest team in the league to sack, Pioneers still picked up a sack against the LR Bears. There's your tell the tape and our player profile. Frankie DeBusk will rejoin us and we'll wrap up a controversial ending to the Tusculum Lenoir Rhyne Bears contest. That's when the Frankie DeBusk Show continues right after this.
Andrew Johnson Bank was founded on conservative banking principles. Over the last 30 years, they have steadily built their balance sheet and increased capital by following prudent lending principles and avoiding risky investments. In uncertain times, you can continue to count on Andrew Johnson Bank, your locally owned community bank. A strong heritage, a stronger future. Andrew Johnson Bank, member FDIC. This will be Marshall, makes a move at the 10, to the 5, walks into the end zone, touchdown Pioneers. Brian Marshall's second career touchdown.
Pioneers fall to the Lenoir Rhyne Bears, ranked 23rd in the country. There's a stat flying out there, the 41st time that the Pioneer football program has played a ranked opponent. And when the Pioneers win 11 of those games, 8 times they've been 1-point games. This one was a 3-point game. It was a 3-overtime game, and it was a loss for the Tusculum Pioneers to the Bears. How do you erase it? How do you get over that? I think that's your biggest challenge this week as you get ready for Newberry.
Well, we just got to regroup. Our kids have, you know, kids are going to rebound. They really are. The coaches, they may not. It may take some time, but our players, they'll watch the film. They'll learn from their mistakes. They'll be excited about the plays that were made. They'll talk about it for years. We just got to figure out a way now to take what we – the successes that we had and continue to move on those, and the failures that we just had, the missed tackles, the drop balls, the things that we didn't do well, we got to learn from those. We got to regroup. We got to clean it all up. We got to go back to work. And that's what football is fortunately about, college football. They get an opportunity to play again next week. So we got to put that behind us and move on.
Now you got to get ready for the Wolves. By far, they probably look like the best team in the league as far as their stature, size, skill set. They get beaten by Jacksonville, and then they just demolished North Greenville, who took Lenoir Rhyne to the woodshed. And so right now, early in the season, it's really hard to figure out who's got what, I guess.
You know, I don't know the answers to that. I'm not really concerned. I know that we got to do what we do good. We got to fix what we did bad, and we got to worry about Tusculum College. But you're exactly right. Newberry is a scary football team. They always have athletes. They always make plays. It's going to be a great environment when we get over there to Newberry on Saturday, and you know we've traditionally played pretty good over there, so we'll see if we can get fired up about it and go find a way to win the ball game. I know we'll have a good week of practice, and you know this loss hurts, and it hurts for a couple of days, but we got to put it behind us and get ready for Newberry.
You know, Michael, he tends to play more quarterbacks. You're not really sure, I guess, maybe who you're going to see all the time. It's a different type of an offense than you've seen that spread. They spread you out. Mm-hmm. They run more of that mm-hmm. jet sweep. So this is more of a running style of a football team.
Yeah, their quarterback, actually the quarterback that started the first two games didn't play Saturday. I think he got hurt last week, but they're still playing two other guys. They're playing one that can throw it really well and one that's really athletic, and they like to, you know, do a lot offensively and screw you up a little bit with formations and motions, and it's hard to defend. And then defensively, they look like the Green Bay Packers when they come walking off the bus. They got some great athletes over there, and we just got to execute and do our part.
Two games away from home. Coach, best of luck.
Thank you very much, Brian.
Pioneer coach Frankie DeBusk as Tusculum takes on the Newberry Wolves on Saturday. And it's always, yes, great atmosphere. So if you're in the neighborhood, just down I-26 as you head towards Columbia, stop by Newberry. It's just off the interstate, some 3.7 miles, just past the graveyard on your left. But you won't have to know that, because all you have to do is see the great atmosphere, the tailgating, and the wonderful barbecuing that they have there at Newberry. Always a great visit, always a great place to go, and hopefully a big win for the Pioneers. Join us as our coverage begins on the Pioneer Sports Network at 3 o'clock. They'll kick it off at 4 o'clock, Setzler Field in Newberry, South Carolina. For everyone involved with the Pioneer Sports Network and the Frankie DeBusk Show, Luke Manning, Nathan Humbert, he's Coach Frankie DeBusk, I'm Brian Stayton. Until next week, go Pioneers.
This has been the Frankie DeBusk Show with head coach Frankie DeBusk, featuring coaches' interviews, player spotlights, highlights, and statistical breakdowns.
Presented by your Greenville Light and Power System, serving Greenville and Greene County since 1945. Andrew Johnson Bank, a strong heritage, a stronger future. Home-owned and operated with locations in Johnson City, Jonesboro, Morristown, Cleveland, and Greenville. Special consideration from Comcast Cable through Xfinity.